Hello and welcome to our channel. We're Andre and Lisa. We've been traveling together as a couple for 20 years, exploring more than 50 countries. Since 2018, we've embraced a full-time nomadic lifestyle, aiming to make travel a sustainable and long-term way of life. For the past 3 years, we've been winding our way around Europe with our 22-year-old motorhome, Millie. This year, we've had some incredible adventures, including a two-month journey through Morocco, 7 weeks in Sardinia, and a wonderful summer in Denmark. In the coming months, we'll be heading south via some new destinations to escape the winter chill. So hit that subscribe button and join us on our adventure.
Welcome back to our channel. Welcome to Poland and welcome to Wrocław.
Yes, we're in Poland and normally we don't travel to a lot of cities.
Hey man.
Normally we don't do a lot of cities, but when in Poland, you have to do the cities because we've never been in Poland. If you haven't seen our last video, we spent a few days exploring both the cities of Szczecin and Poznan. Very nice, actually. But there was one disaster. We didn't eat enough Polish food. So this is why we're in Wrocław. We have to try a few more things. So this is not the 10 best things to do and see in Wrocław.
This is the 10 best things to eat in Wrocław.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, we actually plan on spending a bit more time getting here, but we left Poznan and we had two strikes with parking and didn't work out. We ended up driving in the dark.
We drove into the sunset, arrived at a very beautiful little park up, but in the dark and through a very, very narrow and tree-lined alleyway.
We are in Wrocław. Wrocław. Such a cool name. Wrocław. We're actually standing at the Polish Soldiers' War Memorial. It's for the Second World War. And we also parked here. There's a convenient free parking and it is on park for night. And you can overnight here. Apparently it's a bit noisy because there's a tram station, bus station here, but we might risk it and we're going to take the tram. So
we're getting used to stopping and sleeping with the trains.
But Wrocław's got a very good public transport system. You can buy a 24-hour ticket for the equivalent of 15 zlotys, less than 4 euros for the day, or you can pay per ride depending on the duration of the ride. It starts at 350, 375 zlotys. If it goes over 30 minutes, it's 4 zlotys per ride, so it's less than a euro. We use the app to do it, and the moment you buy it, they're validated. Shall we go?
Let's go eat, because I'm starving.
If you haven't done so yet, remember to subscribe if you want to see what we're up to. Let's go. Minutes later, we find ourselves in Wrocław. Wrocław is the third largest city in Poland, and it was a fifth of its population is made out of students.
More than 100,000.
Crazy, eh?
We want to cross here. We've stopped in the four denominations district. So in this area, you'll see four churches: Catholic, Protestant, Orthodox, and a synagogue. But we are here for none of those. We are here for food. I think the first thing we're going to have is a very typical Polish fast food, which Andre is not very keen on. And it's called the zapiekanka. Now that looks quite proper.
That's saucy.
Wow. Now this is a toasted baguette. They kind of call it the Polish pizza. And traditionally, it's topped with mushrooms and cheese and some ketchup.
For me, cheese and mushrooms don't go together. And if you add ketchup to something, it feels like I'm at McDonald's. I'm not a ketchup guy.
I say if you need to add ketchup to something, that says something about the food.
It's not bad. It's nice and crispy.
I think it's quite nice because it's actually got a pizza-like base. It's not really baguette-like. It's really pizza, nice, light, fluffy pizza dough-like.
Don't get me wrong. I'll eat it. This was 21 zlotys. Not cheap either.
You can get them for about 16 to 18, but then they might not be as nice.
Oh, jeez. Okay. Frankly, for 5 euros, I think I can do better. But it's good. Try it. You know, often when you go to foreign countries, the local McDonald's has got something very unique. So we're going to pop in there and just see, and also get an interesting comparison between McDonald's as street food, fast food, considering if we just paid 21 zlotys for a toasted bread. This is a comparison. Yeah. There's a horrible anti-flicker vibes here. Not bad.
What?
19 zlotys, eh?
All of that. But unfortunately, they don't have anything exciting. So normally, like McDonald's, always have something that's a little bit more local flavor. So we're curious to see what that is. But I don't see anything that looks different.
Jagodzianki. Paki pistachiosi.
We are here for the pukski, yes. Now the traditional one is filled with rose jam, rose marmalade.
Hello.
Oh.
Wow. Whoa, did you see this? Here, is that the rose marmalade?
Yeah.
This is the one that is traditional for here. Okay.
We went in to buy one donut. We came in out of three.
Comparatively, 27 zloty. We've got three homemade, handmade, fancy things.
Beautiful little square.
Lovely.
Oh, nice. And believe it or not, this flower seller stall here is open 24 hours a day. You can literally come here any time of the day and get some flowers. Interesting about the city is that it's known for not actually having a lot of like commercial shops, retail shops, and it's got a massive amount of restaurants and eateries. Oh, Lisa's going for it. Can we see the inside?
Not yet, no.
I'll be able to reach the center.
I think you reached the center.
Oh, buddy. Oh, did you?
What does rose jelly, rose marmalade taste like?
It's a bloody good donut.
Ooh, it doesn't taste like roses, which is what I was afraid of. And yes, it's a lovely donut.
And this is a speciality of the city. And this one from that bakery was 7 zlotys.
Very good.
Breakfast of champions. So that's not a donut.
It looks like choux pastry. It's a choux pastry with a nice icing on top.
Yep. I like this day so far. Happy Lisa. Your last one. For now.
This is also a donut. Clearly donuts are not just donuts here, that's for sure. And this one is filled with pistachio cream.
Ooh.
I can say that when I read that donuts are a Polish thing, I was like, oh, that's so boring. Like, oh wow, a donut. These are not just donuts.
Mm.
Poland does donuts right.
Yummy. Oh, it's quite it's like a pistachio cream.
Wow.
This approves. Quick stop at the town square.
This is one of the biggest market squares in Europe.
Where's the market?
In fact, only the market squares in Krakow and Olek are bigger. We're still going to the market hall, which is where the market is today, and that's a different place. But this is the market square. One of the places you can get a nice view out over the city is from the Bridge of Penitence, which is a little bridge linking two of the church towers, which was destroyed during World War II, but rebuilt in 2001.
Well, we're not going up there.
No, we're going up somewhere else.
What?
Taking a photo of the dwarf,
taking a photo of a dwarf.
Now, if you don't know, dwarf hunting is a thing to do here in Wroclaw.
How do the dwarves feel about it?
I don't think they mind. There are over 800 dwarves in the city.
Story of the dwarves in Wroclaw is really quite interesting. And go back to the early 1980s, where there was a sort of a silent protest against the then Soviet and communist system. But as it was, whenever graffiti was used as a protest method, it was painted over. So in 1982, the underground opposition movement started using the dwarf as a symbol, and they painted it over freshly painted graffiti. Eventually it sort of moved towards using orange as a sign of pushback against the red of communism, and members wore orange headgear.
And the first bronze dwarf was actually only placed in 2001 In 2005, there were another five, and now that's multiplied to over 800 little bronze dwarves all over the city. Yeah. It's just crazy.
Oh, yeah, we can see the other side of the square.
There we go.
Beautiful.
I take it back. This is quite a big market
square. Yeah, and the square, it goes all around the center building, so it is massive, massive. We're heading for that tower over there.
Yes, we're going to go all the way to the top of that church tower, hopefully.
All these sandbags we see lying around the city at the moment is as a result of preparation against the flood risk that was recently experienced in the south-southwest of Poland. You know, here we have this church. Now, you can go up this tower. You see there's some people up there. But you have to climb all the way up.
Over 300 steps that we have to climb. Are you ready to work up those donuts?
Okay, it's going to take a while. 300 steps. Go. Oh, hey,
we made
two steps already. I'm going to be, like, dizzy. We're almost there. Oh, I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Free at last.
Oh.
Whoa. Whoa. All right. Beautiful square below us. It's all this glory.
Wow. So from the bridge over there, you can see this, and from here, we can see that. Bridge of Penitence.
Mm. It costs 15 zlotys to get up here, but it's probably worth it because you can get like a 360 view, although you feel like you're in jail. You can see the river on the side. You can see the full market square on the other side. You see how brown the river is. There's still more evidence of flood prevention down there. So this city has, depending on how you count, got over 100 bridges.
And there are some really pretty bridges too.
Ah. Now there's an amazing suspension bridge there in the distance to the left.
Is that the one we drove over?
Yeah, that's one of the longest in Poland, eh? Drove over that in sunset the other night. Stunning.
Definitely well worth the efforts to climb that 304 steps to get up here and see the view. Stunning.
Ooh. Of course, you can also go into the church, which is free, and you can witness an incredible organ that was completely destroyed in a fire in 1979. After many, many years, it was decided that they had to try and rebuild this organ, and today there is a perfect reconstruction of the original organ. Pretty cool. Let's go find some food.
Yes.
Quick stop at what's now known as Butcher's Alley. It used to be where all the butchers were based that served the market square.
And it says, we honor the animals that were slaughtered, and it's written from the consumer. But I might have to pop into this little shop. It says I've got the cheapest souvenirs in Wrocław.
Thing is, if you're on the road like us, we don't have a home. We don't have a home, by the way. We currently travel full-time, and we have been for the last 6 years. And whatever we own is actually in the motorhome with us. There's no space for souvenirs. At least I have ideas. What do you see?
I want to see. I want to maybe get something.
All right, I'll wait here.
We're at Zesmakim, which is a little restaurant here with only three tables. But what's so cool is that you can watch them making the pierogi right here by hand. We've got the traditional, which is potato and cheese. And then we've also got a pork.
Oh, this is pink.
And both of them come with a cream cheese.
All right, let's try.
Wow. Okay, that is really, really tasty. This is supposed to be pork. And both of us think that it smells and tastes exactly like a chicken pie. So I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Well, it's very nice, though. Chicken pie.
I guess it's just a really meaty stock flavor. Mm. This is a very substantial portion for 23 and 31 zlotys per portion.
I think we both officially stuffed like a pierogi.
But man, that was delicious.
That was good. Go check these guys out. Although there were only like five people in the place, and when we walked out, they were like, hey, you guys haven't paid. And we're like, well, we have. How can you not remember? There's only five of us here.
No,
in fact, two tables.
Two tables, five people, literally.
That was weird.
Very strange.
Anyway.
But definitely, absolutely excellent pierogi.
Because now we're in the heart of the university district, eh?
Behind us is not only the beautiful big university building, but also the mathematical tower, which you can climb up.
Yeah, back in the day.
Maybe.
That used to be the mathematical department.
Yeah, it's really cool. They got some scales on the one side.
So today, this building houses the museum, which consists of the mathematical tower, as you can see. Oopsie. Oh, sorry.
Now, this is the door that all the graduates come and stand in front of when they receive their degree.
Okay.
So we'll just pretend that I'm receiving my degree.
I'll give you an honorary doctorate in pierogi eating.
Ooh, yes. I like that.
Although we can't stomach the idea of food right now, we stuck our heads into what's called a milk bar.
And the selection is actually quite incredible. Now, these milk bars were started by a Polish dairy farmer in Warsaw. It was called a milk bar because it was made from so many dairy products. And they became very popular after World War II when there was government-subsidized food available here. And very typical Polish cuisine. And today it still serves typical Polish cuisine at very good value.
So this one, yeah, it's a little bit more trendy. It's right opposite the main university building. But you can actually get more local where food is absolutely quite ridiculously cheap. You can probably stuff yourself for the equivalent of 10, 12, 15 zlotys. But it's very, very traditional food here. This is a little bit more trendy.
Maybe we'll come back later.
Okay, it looks like a bar of soap, but it's not.
It's called Zippik, and it's a smoked sheep's milk cheese, and what makes it quite iconic is the pattern in which it's formed. Well, this is a single piece. I thought it was two pieces together.
Ooh, I smell the smokiness.
This is very strange, tasting a piece of cheese.
No, it's what I'm made for.
Ooh, squeaky. But you can tell that it's sheep's milk. It's very, very flavorful. I quite like it because I like a smoked cheese.
Salty, squeaky.
I heard there were South Africans in the house. We got the plates nailed down and the fork. You can just about get it to your mouth. That is brilliant.
I guess the idea is to create some sort of a diner look here. Nice.
Oh, that's the one. That's the Bar Malaysia. That was one of the original, I think, mukbangs here.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I think we walked enough and worked up enough of an appetite to justify going back to a mukbang.
Maybe we're just doing it for the camera, you know.
We'll promise to behave and hopefully just have something small. Maybe we'll just look. Maybe. All right, back at the bar.
All right.
Shall we take one plate?
Yes.
Your massive pierogies. I have to admit, this is the saddest looking plate ever. But Lisa had to try a few weird things. I just wanted to try the tart, but Lisa wanted all this stuff.
Yes, it's a nice opportunity to be able to just taste like a single thing and not have to order a full portion. And this entire plate was 20 zlotys, so that's €5. And I mean, it could have been a substantial meal.
You could have chosen better. You could have chosen better.
We did it. We managed to eat more.
I think we're going to take a walk back to the square and find the train back to Mali. Unless you can think of something else to eat.
Oh, I'm sure I can. Oh. We got back past your bakery.
It's 6 o'clock and we've been, I think, eating every hour. But anyway, that was good fun. So far's been an interesting and fun city. Very walkable. Nice. No shops, eh?
Very nice city to walk around. No chain shops.
You don't see shops. It's just restaurants. There's a bookshop. Does it count?
You don't take one with you?
No. I'm running away. Lisa's trying to drag me into the donut store. You know?
You sure?
Look.
I'm offering you a donut.
No. Come. Don't say, I don't bring you to those places. Whoa.
When you hear the rumble, it's like, is it a train or is it a plane?
In all fairness, I don't recommend sleeping here. We don't
We deal with noise quite well, but it's super convenient. But man, the rumbling of the trains from 5 a.m. is not good. We are live. Went for a nice run in this forest. It's still a very convenient spot. So if you do travel to the city with your motorhome, park here, take the tram, works for us. I think we're going to move on. We actually decided this morning we're going to go into the direction of Krakow. Krakow? I think we said it right. You try.
Krakow?
Krakow.
Krakow?
Yeah, you have to roll the R.
And you have to put more emphasis on the first syllable Krakow. With the consonants.
My first breakfast. We got a bit of a drive ahead of us. We're probably going to take a day or two to get there. Hopefully today we're going to find one nice chill spot to have a relaxed evening, catch up with some work. But first breakfast. Lisa's happy because she's getting breakfast.
First coffee.
Ooh. Proper breakfast. This breakfast is the best part of the day. So we have some burrata, avocado, smoked bacon, grilled tomatoes.
We have some of our leftover Polish cheese.
Good morning.
Dink. Good morning to you.
This is where we ended up, desperately looking for a slightly more peaceful place than yesterday. It's one of these forest parkings, actually official parking lot. Quite a bit of drive actually, we did about 200 kilometers now. Funny enough, I still hear the roads. Quite a bit of bad weather forecast for the next day. I think we're just going to take a break.
It's already gotten really cold suddenly.
Yeah, it's quite cold. Some rain forecast. Hopefully we're not under trees too much.
The acorns falling worries me a little bit. I just heard one drop.
Why don't we end this video here, Lisa?
Let's end it here. We will leave Krakow
for next video.
Because we need a break before the next city.
It's going to be our last city stop in Poland. And it's been city. So we're quite exhausted, actually. We still haven't quite decided on our route south. But I think we're going to hightail it through Slovakia and Hungary into Croatia. Also a country we actually haven't seen a lot of.
Croatia.
So if you want to follow our adventures, remember to smash the like button, hit the subscribe button, ring the notification bell.
And leave us a comment down below. And thanks for watching.
Yeah, as always, thank you for watching. And if you've made it this far, we'll see you next time.
Bye.